There's some major news on the heat between MJF and AEW president Tony Khan, and Bray Wyatt has confirmed his wrestling return and could be heading to either AEW or WWE. But first, two top AEW stars have picked up injuries. Ahead of tonight's Los Angeles edition of AEW Dynamite, AEW president Tony Khan would take to Twitter to confirm that both Adam Cole and Jeff Hardy will not be competing on the show despite them being advertised due to sustaining injuries at Double or Nothing this past weekend. The show was originally set to see AEW World Tag Team Champions Jungle Boy and Luchasaurus, as well as Christian Cage and the Hardys, taking on the Young Bucks, Adam Cole and Red Dragon of the Undisputed Elite in a 10-man tag match. Cole and Hardy have instead been replaced by Darby Allin, who joins the Babyface team, whilst Bullet Club's Hikuleo joins up with the Undisputed Elite. In kayfabe, both teams were allowed to pick their replacement, with the Young Bucks interestingly opting for a member of their former stable. No return dates are known for either Jeff Hardy or Adam Cole, but we'll keep you updated should any further news break. Next up, a top free agent has revealed a brand new ring name. Back in April, WWE would release NXT superstar Dakota Kai from her contract as part of the continual releases. This week, the now free agent would reveal her new look, rocking pink, grey and black hair, while confirming she will now be known as King Kota. She would file for the trademark on May 9th and can now appear on wrestling shows with the name after her non-compete clause recently expired. It was recently revealed that whilst she was released on April 29th, her deal was set to end in April 2023 and she had no intention of re-signing with the company. It was later suggested in the Wrestling Observer newsletter that WWE didn't view her as, quote, main roster material after appearing in a number of dark matches in January. Either way, King Kota is now free to work elsewhere, although it's currently unknown what her future holds in wrestling. Next up, three New Japan stars are set to miss an upcoming show. This week, New Japan Pro-Wrestling will host the final of the Best of the Super Juniors tournament, a show that will see Hiromu Takahashi and El Desperado fight it out for the trophy. On top of this, a number of other matches are booked, although some top names have now been pulled. New Japan would release a statement which read, after previously being announced as appearing at the Nippon Budokan for June 3rd's Best of the Super Juniors final, Carl Anderson and Will Ospreay will not be able to attend for medical reasons, and Tangaloa has sustained an injury and is not cleared to participate. Will Ospreay is currently recovering from a kidney infection, while Carl Anderson has received a positive PCR test for COVID. Tangaloa has sustained an injury to his right knee. It's unknown when the three men will return to action, with no specific timeframes being given. This also ends any rumours that Will Ospreay could be heading to AEW tonight at the Forum, with maybe a Forbidden Door debut expected ahead of the event later this month. With that said, be sure to let me know your predictions for the Best of the Super Juniors final between Hiromu Takahashi and El Desperado in the comments down below. And next up, we have a major update on the heat between Tony Khan and MJF. This past week, MJF would cause quite a bit of a stir when he failed to show up for an official AEW meet and greet, as his unhappiness with the company continues to grow. Well, in a new report, one of the reasons for his unhappiness has been revealed, as the man that claims to be better than you is earning significantly less than some of his colleagues on the roster. Despite a pay rise in January of this year, he is said to be earning significantly less money than a lot of ex-WWE stars such as CM Punk, Bryan Danielson, Christian Cage, Jon Moxley, Chris Jericho and Adam Cole. This according to Wade Keller of PW Torch. On top of this, Keller would speak on PW Torch's audio show this week where he revealed that in 2019, MJF started at around $40,000 to $70,000 per year but is now making hundreds of thousands of dollars, although no specific salary was given. Despite being one of the most talented guys on the roster, he is still earning less than a lot of the talent, which is one of his ongoing gripes with the company. And Keller would say, in many cases, those wrestlers are getting paid four or five times more than him. So, you know, MJF is, by all accounts, is kind of fuming over this. He felt that his work, his professionalism, his rapport, and friendship with Tony Khan would have led to Tony renegotiating his deal when there was about 2 years left on MJF's contract. And by the time January 1st, 2022 came around, yes, he got a new contract and a raise, But MJF was thinking, hey, come on, Tony, approach me, get me on the level of some of these people that you keep bringing in. I'm doing great work and I'm drawing great ratings. And when Tony didn't do that, MJF, the way he handled it was to get very angry privately, and then it kind of exploded. And I think Tony was caught off guard by how angry MJF was getting. Keller would then go on to say that MJF segments do better ratings than most of the AEW roster, but his value to the company isn't reflected in his salary, at least that's how he feels. He would then go on to discuss MJF's relationship with AEW president Tony Khan and said, MJF and Tony Khan were really close as recently as late last year. MJF was one of those wrestlers that Khan would have long phone conversations with about ideas for storylines and matches. At some point, that relationship fractured, and the real reason might be as simple as MJF feels disrespected that Tony didn't approach him with the new contract offer sooner. It's possible something else triggered or amplified this situation, but that hasn't been even hinted at in reports elsewhere or from our sources. But some people are wondering that, is there something else we don't know about? Following the weekend's controversy, MJF did end up wrestling at Double or Nothing despite speculation that he wouldn't be there. That said, he lost in emphatic fashion before being stretchered out of the building, although this was likely the plan anyway. Tonight, the post-Double or Nothing episode of AEW Dynamite will air from Los Angeles, California at the Forum, and MJF has been spotted in the city, with him said to be there to meet up with Tony Khan to discuss the situation. It's previously been reported that MJF wants more money whilst not extending his contract beyond its current expiry date of January 2024, whilst AEW wants to lock him down beyond that. Whether an agreement can be made remains to be seen, but stay subscribed to the channel for any further updates on the situation. And just as a quick edit before I upload this video, it's just been announced literally 5 minutes ago that MJF will be on AEW Dynamite tonight from Los Angeles, with AEW releasing a graphic simply saying, "We hear from MJF," which will likely be another high-rated segment for the Long Island Native. But let me know what you think MJF will say in tonight's unpredictable promo in the comments down below. And finally, Bray Wyatt has confirmed his wrestling return and could be heading to either AEW or WWE. Ever since his WWE release back in July 2021, speculation has surrounded the former Fiend and his future in the wrestling business. He's yet to make an appearance inside a ring, with his only wrestling-related booking being for a meet and greet on top of his recent work in a yet-to-be-released horror movie. Well, last night, Wyatt himself would set the rumor mill on fire when he sent out a number of tweets that suggested his return was imminent. Before we get to the tweets, however, as many of you already know, he would recently change his social media name to his real name of Wyndham. However, he has now switched it back to simply Wyatt, posting an interesting photo of a flying insect, which appears to be either a moth, butterfly, or even a firefly, wearing the Fiend mask with red scribbles on top. And if there's any insect experts out there, let me know what it is in the comments down below. This seems to suggest that he's either returning as the Fiend, or he is moving on to a new character. On top of this, he would post 3 tweets which state that he is now ready and it's almost time, and he would write, "Everything good that's ever happened to me first came from a period of horrible suffering. I never ask why, I just wait for the rough part to end. I was chosen for whatever reason, and I've got to do. It doesn't hurt anymore, it burns. I'm ready now." Wyatt would then seem to address reports of a high asking price for a return, which led to some critics calling him greedy, to which he responded, "I'm tired of watching, tired of hearing irrelevant clowns speculate how I'll be perceived, tired of hearing about my greed, my desire questioned. Wherever and whenever I decide to return, I'll remind everyone why they know my name again and again. Believe in me. Hashtag I found it." He then ended with 4 simple words, "Patience, it's almost time." Going back to the Twitter name change, the fact that he changed it to Wyatt could suggest a WWE return. However, this may not be the case. Technically, the surname Wyatt could be used if he were to go to another promotion, much like we saw with Aleister Black becoming Malakai Black, so I won't take this as confirmation of him being WWE bound. It's worth noting that this was the day before AEW Dynamite tonight, who air the show live from the historic Forum in Los Angeles, so perhaps that's a possible location for his debut. As well as this, missed WWE present Hell in a Cell this weekend, so perhaps he could show up there too, although that pay-per-view won't conjure up the best of memories for him. Some fans have pointed out that Wyatt has referred to Cody Rhodes as the butterfly in past tweets, although I don't think the insect is a butterfly, but perhaps that is a link. Either way, it's great to hear that Wyatt is coming back to wrestling, whether it be WWE or AEW, and let me know your predictions for his destination in the comments down below. And before you go, make sure you check out 10 things that you didn't know about AEW's Hook.